point has neither length nor width. This is the simplest and most important object in geometry, and at the same time it gives rise to a lot of questions and problems. Only in the 20th century did it become clear that a point can't even be given an exact definition. In contrast, a segment has both a definition and even a length. You can notice an orange spot on it. This is a main character. Consider that he is two-dimensional and is now breaking through the second dimension. Euclid wrote that the line is a length without breadth, and the extremities of a line are points. Finding himself on a segment, Orange is surprised by the boundary points and the emptiness beyond them. By the way, points in geometry are denoted in capital Latin letters. In the beginning there was a word, after all. For the sake of experiment, the stickman throws point C, a natural transition from physics to geometry. Unlike a segment, a ray has a direction, but a ray starts from a point too. Another important concept. Angle. Now it's formed by the intersection of the ray and the segment. And then we see one of the very first cool theorems of geometry. Vertical angles are equal. Perpendicular lines occupy a special place. By the way, Euclid himself considered right angles to be primary. Now he would say that the sum of the supplementary angles is equal to two right angles. And here's a division of a segment in a given ratio, and the fundamental concept in geometry and analysis to lie between. Flash and the main character is puzzled. Some length ratio will be important in this story. Each time a golden beam cuts through the screen where the ratio becomes slightly more than 1.6. And yes, this is a golden ratio. Now it's indeed appropriate to call it divine proportion. This famous constant in mathematics is denoted by the Greek letter phi. The root of 3 helps to understand how the beautiful triangle turned out later. The unknown frightens the main character at first, and having stumbled on a point, he almost fell into the void. But now the segments turn into a polyline with a right angle. And using a polyline, it's no longer difficult to define a triangle. And what a beautiful triangle it turns out to be, with angles of 30, 60 and 90 degrees. Someone will remember the property of leg lying opposite an angle of 30 degrees. The picture is completed to a centrally symmetrical figure, a rectangle. It's appropriate to say here, alternate angles are equal. Another important type of motion, rotation. Third type of motion, reflex symmetry. Rotation again. Next, the original triangle is completed to form a parallelogram. The figure turns into a square. The diagonals of a square, as you remember, are perpendicular. From the regular quadrangle, the figure turns into a truly golden pentagon. And then the number of sides of a polygon grows with each frame. And in the limit, the figure coincides with the circle. This reminds us of the number pi and the proof of the circle's area formula. Now attention! One of the simplest and most beautiful theorems of geometry proven by Thales of Miletus. An inscribed angle subtended by the diameter of a circle is a right angle. The position of the point at which the acute angles are equal to 38 and 52 degrees is highlighted. It will soon become clear why. On the freeze frame, you can see the circumference, pi times phi. Once again, it's appropriate to click on pause. If the legs of the right triangle are 1 and the root of phi, then hypotenuse will be exactly equal to phi, a beautiful property of the golden ratio. Moreover, for such proportions, the angles of the triangle will be approximately 38 degrees, 52 and 90. What do you think is the theorem we are heading towards now? The main character does not yet realize the connection between the numbers, although perhaps he understands that I squared, B squared and C squared are the areas of the constructed squares. Euclid, speaking about the squares of the legs, literally means squares, quadrangles. The golden assistant lifting the biggest square hints to the second coming with his entire appearance at the other two squares, and then insight occurs. Without changing the area, Orange constructs the biggest square from the two small squares, having the area of C squared. On the first frame, there is another equation with phi. The discovery of the Pythagorean theorem brings the heroes together and helps them unite against the villain, who appears out of nowhere from another dimension. It's clear that we have a planar graph, but isn't a projection of some polyhedron as the movement hints at. I counted its vertices, 24. The degree of each vertex in the picture is more difficult to determine, but it looks like it's 8. In this case, the graph has 96 edges, and here everything falls into place, since these parameters and triangular two-dimensional faces hint at a 24-cell polytop, which I will further call Octaplex. Octaplex, great name for a villain. This is one of the 6 regular four-dimensional polytop. Moreover, it has no analogs in three-dimensional space, which fits perfectly for this story. With each blow, the octoplex reveals the fractal essence of the figure, as if crushing its dimension. So hidden behind the square is the famous fractal, the Sierpinski carpet. Next comes fight choreography and a chase scene, accompanied by dynamic music. At some point, the number 5 breaks down into a continued fraction. This fraction is also a kind of fractal. The second coming arms himself with the darts and shoots at Octaplex. The arrows are reflected, flying off at a different angles, which are carefully labeled. Next, the number 5 turns off the road and begins to draw the famous approach of the golden spiral, along which the stickman escapes from pursuit. But the ancient Greek hero of the Iliad, Octaplex, breaks through the dimensions like a drill. At some point, a triangle appears with angles of 54, 54 and 72 degrees. It's related to the golden ratio and also to the kite and dart tiling. But now, there is no longer any doubt about 24 cell. The fact is that its faces are triangles and cells are regular octahedrons. And we see that in the animation, the villain shoots with octahedrons. The kite is completed to form a rhombus, still with golden angles. The fight continues. Let me remind you that by a happy coincidence, on the channel we discuss fractals. The link is below, and video about golden ratio is coming soon. Well, now there is a nice picture. The diagonals of a regular pentagon are divided in the golden ratio. Golden triangles fly like arrows. Each hit causes fractal damage, but this time the small particles look like pentagons. Golden rectangles are thrown from the fortress walls. While the battle is going on, the number 5 explains the counter-offensive plan. It's necessary to build a polyhedron that will catch the villain like a cage and then destroy him using homotety, space compression. And now we see two edges and then a completely regular tetrahedron. And this is one of the 5 platonic solids that is now catching the octoplex. And he can't get out of the walls of the pyramid anywhere. The cage turns into another regular polyhedron, an octahedron. And then a very beautiful fact awaits us. If we mark the center of each face of the octahedron, that will make 8 vertices. Do you know how many vertices a cube has? 8. In addition, the octahedron has 6 vertices and the cube has 6 faces. And they each have a dozen edges. Such polyhedrons are called dual. After the crash, the villain breaks out, and two friends begin to build a new polyhedron using 3 golden rectangles. The 90-degree rotation emphasizes the third dimension. 12 vertices, 20 triangular faces, and 30 edges. Before us is the fourth platonic solid, icosahedron. However, it seems that he can't hold the octaplex either. Therefore, the golden constant remembers its parent regular pentagon and begins construction. Plato associated each polyhedron with an element – fire, water, air, earth – 4 in total. But there are 5 regular polyhedrons, and about the last one, Plato only vaguely said that the god used it for arranging the constellations on the whole heaven. This last platonic solid is called dodecahedron. Each of its dozen faces is a regular pentagon. It's dodecahedron that allows heroes to defeat evil. The Phi character sacrificed himself. In the background, we see a fractal resembling the dragon curve. If the second coming walks in a straight line, then the dodecahedron lands as if on a plane. Looking inside, the hero discovers his own reflections, as well as 4D polytops. A pentatop is flying right now. It's as if we were in a world of forms. Or maybe this is a hint at the multi-universe and multidimensionality of our space? After all, the video about physics already featured string theory, and it's no coincidence that a cowboy hat appears. In the finale, on the two-dimensional screen, we see a one-dimensional straight line and a familiar point that has neither length nor width. Think critically, do math, take care!